In this video, we set up multi-factor authentication for Windows Virtual Desktop. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Seraltos. In this video, we're going over setting up multi-factor authentication, or MFA, for Windows Virtual Desktop users with a conditional access policy. Before that, please like, subscribe, and share, and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. Username and passwords have been a part of computing ever since I can remember, but that alone is not considered by many sufficient to secure an environment. Usernames are easily guessed and passwords can become compromised. Multi-factor authentication adds another, well, factor to the verification process. Azure AD has an integrated MFA platform that can work with a phone, SMS, or an authenticator application available for iOS and Android devices. Adding an additional factor to user logins enhances the security posture of an organization. We use a conditional access policy to enable MFA in this video. A conditional access policy is an if-this-then-that style rule built into Azure AD for enforcing or blocking logins under specific conditions. Let's start with the requirements. Azure AD Premium P1 or P2 is required to enable conditional access policies. If you don't have Azure AD Premium, you can still use MFA by enabling the Azure AD security defaults on the tenant. This enables a default set of policies that apply to the tenant. One of those will require MFA for all users. Security defaults is a good alternative, and if you don't have Azure AD Premium, it's recommended to enable it. Matter of fact, newly deployed tenants have this enabled by default. Security defaults enables other settings, such as blocking legacy authentication. It enables MFA for all users. There's no way to modify the security defaults. More granular control for security settings requires Azure AD Premium P1 or P2. Next, let's talk about the Windows Virtual Desktop login process. The Windows Virtual Desktop service is an Azure PaaS service. Initial authentication takes place with Azure AD. This is where we apply the MFA conditional access policy. Once the user logs into the Windows Virtual Desktop service, then they have to authenticate to the session host. This is the case for both published apps and desktops. The second authentication is an Active Directory Domain Services login, either Windows AD or Azure AD Domain Services. We are not applying MFA at this point. These session hosts are not exposed directly to the internet and only available after the users log into the Windows Virtual Desktop service. Coming up, we're going to target a group of users for MFA. This is the same user group assigned to accessing Windows Virtual Desktop. By using the same user group, we can ensure that MFA conditional access policy is applied consistently to all users. The goal of the demo coming up is to create a policy that enforces MFA for users outside of the office. At a high level, the policy will be enforced on the Windows Virtual Desktop user group when they are accessing Windows Virtual Desktop. If they're coming from a non-trusted network with the web or the desktop client, MFA will be required, and they'll have to re-authenticate every hour after they first sign in. Let's get started in the portal to walk through setting up our conditional access policy. Let's start by adding our trusted IPs. This is one or more known safe public IP address your users will be coming from. When a user signs in from this location, they will not get the MFA prompt. From the Azure portal, go to Azure AD, Security, and Named Locations. There's a link at the top that'll take you to the location to modify MFA trusted IP addresses. Click the link. Under Trusted IPs, add any IP addresses or IP ranges of known safe locations. Most common, this would be the public IP address your office users come from when accessing the internet. If you don't know what that is, simply hop over to a computer on that network, open the web browser, and there's a few sites for this, but if you go to ipchicken.com, that will tell you what your public IP address is. So I'll copy this. I'll paste that in and put a slash 32 at the end. The slash 32 is a subnet range of a single IP address. If you have a larger subnet, you can add a different subnet mask to cover all the IP addresses. I suggest avoiding dynamically assigned IP addresses if a consumer-grade internet connection is in use. Also, if an organization offers public Wi-Fi, that should be on its own public IP and not included in this list. Click Save when finished. We'll close and close the window. Next, go to All Services and search for Conditional Access. There it is, Azure AD Conditional Access. Create a new policy. Start by giving it a name. I'll use WVD MFA for this example. Next, go to Assignments. Assignments are where you assign the policy. We'll use the same group used to assign rights to log into Windows Virtual Desktop. Alternatively, you could select all users. That way, there's no chance someone may get access to Windows Virtual Desktop that are not a member of the group for MFA. Say, for example, a user gets directly assigned to an application group and is not part of the WVD user group. This conditional access policy would not apply to them, and they would not have MFA enforced. If you do select all users, you can add users to exclude. For this example, we'll select a user or group, add a user or group, and search for your group, in my example, WVD users. Click select. Now the rule will apply to all the users in that group. Move on to cloud apps or actions. Here we go to select apps and search for Windows Virtual Desktop. There's a couple that are returned, Windows Virtual Desktop, Windows Virtual Desktop AME, and Windows Virtual Desktop Client. We only want the Windows Virtual Desktop selected. It starts with 9CD. So we'll select that and select. Now let's move on to conditions. Go to locations and set the configure to yes. Leave include as default and go to exclude. We're going to exclude a location from the MFA policy. So select to pick a location. And here it shows the MFA trusted IPs. That includes the IP addresses we added to the MFA trusted site IPs. Click and select. With this setting, anyone coming from a trusted IP will be excluded from the condition. So the MFA policy will not apply for users coming in from the trusted IP. The idea is, if somebody's logging in from their office, they probably don't need MFA applied. Next, go to Client Apps, set Configure to Yes. Under the Client Apps this policy will apply to, leave Browser and Mobile Apps and Desktop Client checked, uncheck Exchange Active Sync Client and Other Clients. This will set the condition to apply if the user logs in with the web browser or the client application coming from any IP address except the ones we excluded. Click Done. Next, under Access Controls, go to Grant. Set this to Require Multi-factor Authentication. This will grant users access once they've fulfilled the requirement of multi-factor authentication. Click Select. Then go to Session. From here, you can set a reauthentication window. The Microsoft default is every 90 days to force reauthentication. 90 days may seem a bit long between reauthentication, but things like password changes, account settings getting disabled, or any other changes in the user's security posture will trigger a reauthentication. Set this to a more frequent sign-in if needed. For this example, I'll set it to once every hour. Select sign-in frequency, change the value to 1, and the unit to hours. And select. Now we need to enable the policy. At the bottom of this page, there's an option for report only, or turn the policy on or off. Leaving it to report only runs it in audit mode, so we can see what happens if the policy is enabled. For now, let's turn it on and click create. Now that it's enabled, let's test. I'm going to open up a new incognito window, and I'll go to Windows Virtual Desktop. This computer is not coming from a MFA trusted network. Log in with a user who's a member of the group we assigned the conditional access policy to. It asks me for more information. We'll click Next. This wizard will walk the user through setting up the Microsoft Authenticator app for multi-factor authentication. We'll click Next to set up the account, open up the Authenticator app, add a work or school account, and scan the QR code. Once done, click Next. It'll send a test, and Next, and done. I'll click No to stay signed in. Now that user account is onboarded to Windows Virtual Desktop and MFA is enabled. Next, let's try connecting with the Windows Remote Desktop client. Open the Remote Desktop client and click Subscribe with URL. Either enter in the workspace URL, or if you have email feed discovery set up, enter in the user's email address. Click Next. In here, I'll go through the same sign-in process. There we go. I've got an approval request in the Authenticator app. I'll approve. And I'll uncheck these for now for the demo. There we are. We've logged in with the web client and the desktop client enforcing MFA. One last thing I want to test. Let's go over to the machine with the public IP address we added into the MFA Trusted IP list. From here, I'll open up the web client. I'll log in with the same user account. I'll click No so I don't stay logged in on this screen. Because I'm accessing Windows Virtual Desktop from a machine behind the public IP address we added to the MFA Trusted Site IP list, I'm not getting prompted for MFA. That's how you set up MFA for Windows Virtual Desktop users. Thanks for joining me. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell icons for notifications of new content. Thanks for watching.